This is an overview of the software-defined radio fixed-point IQ modulator example in Agilent SystemVue. This is IQ modulator design, which consists of fixed-point elements from which we'll generate HDL code for. The IQ modulator basically reads in I and Q data that have been stored in lookup tables or LUTs. And so on the far left-hand side is an index accumulator whose job is to basically count from 0 to the number of I and Q LUT entries that have been stored in the workspace. This is the ILUT element, and if I double click on it, we'll see that it's referencing a variable. That variable is representing an array of I data that have been stored in the workspace. Likewise, if I double click on the Q LUT element, it's referencing a variable, which again represents an array of Q data that has been stored in the workspace. The I and Q data are then upsampled by a factor of 4. They are then root raised cosine filtered using FIR filters. And if I double click on this FIR, we'll see that it's referencing a variable. And again, this variable is storing FIR tap coefficients in the workspace. The I and Q are then multiplexed onto cosine omega CT and sine omega CT using a multiplexing technique as well as an FS over 4 technique to generate a digital carrier from 1/4 of the clock rate that's clocking the design. IFT cosine omega CT is then combined with QFT sine omega CT to generate our digitally modulated IF signal. This is a top-level schematic design in which we've instantiated the IQ modulator as a subnetwork. The output of the IQ modulator is a baseband signal, and so to that we've connected this FC change element, which effectively allows us to recharacterize the signal as a bandpass signal and also assign a carrier frequency of 11.2 MHz. On the far right-hand side, we have our simulation measurement elements. We have a spectrum analyzer sync as well as a vector signal analyzer, or VSA sync. So let's go ahead and perform our simulation. And here are our simulation results. On the upper left is the constellation, the simulated constellation. And the particular waveform that's been implemented in this example is a mobile WiMAX downlink waveform, in which there's multiple bursts being transmitted, each burst using a different constellation type. And so you'll notice that there is QPSK as well as 16 QAM and 64 QAM present on the constellation. On the lower left-hand side is a simulated spectrum. You can see some impairments as a result of the fixed-point nature of our IQ modulator design. Likewise, to the right is error vector magnitude, or EVM, which tends to be a fairly key system-level metric. And you'll notice that EVM is non-ideal. It's around 1.5%, again, resulting from the fixed-point nature of our design. We also have an FIR that has a finite length, and that's introducing impairments to the waveform. Above this is EVM versus subcarrier. And to the right is a main time display, and below that is a frequency response display. So what's particularly nice about using the VSA simulation measurement element to analyze our simulation results is that this is the same measurement software that is used with Agilent test solutions, such as signal analyzers and logic analyzers. And so it's performing simulation measurements with the same user interface and same measurement algorithms in simulation as we would be during test with our test solutions. And this helps to minimize or mitigate surprises as we transition from design to test. Now let's change the precision of our IQ modulator design and see what impact that might have to our simulation results. So let's go ahead and stop the simulation. And let's push into our IQ modulator. And let's change the word length on our ILUT and our QLUT. So currently the word length is set to 10. Let's change this to 6. And let's do the same thing for the QLUT. And let's push back up to the top level and perform our simulation. Okay, these are the new simulation results, and we can see that changing the precision on the I-LUT and the Q-LUT has had a significant impact to our system simulation results. The constellation shows much more dispersion. We see impairments on the spectrum, and EVM has degraded from 1.5% to 4.5%. This kind of capability allows system engineers and baseband engineers to evaluate the baseband requirements for their design in meeting a system level metric such as EVM. Thank you for your time today.